श्रीगुरुभ्यो नमः हरिः ॐ गणानां त्वा गणपतिगुं हवामहे कविं कवीनामुपमश्रवस्तमं ज्येष्ठराजम् आनश्रृण्वन्नोतिभिः सीदसादनं श्रीमहागणाधिपतये नमः सदाशिवसमारम्भां शङ्कराचार्यमध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्ताम् वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम् ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यम् करवावहै ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः यत्र वा अस्य सर्वमात्मैवाभूत् तत्केन कं जिघ्रेत् तत्केन कं पश्येत् तत्केन कं शृणुयात् तत्केन कमभिवदेत् तत्केन कं मन्वीता तत्केन कं विजानीयात् सर्वं आत्मैवाभूत् यत्र यस्मिन् काले उच्चतायम् आर्यस्याम् अवस्थायाम् उच्चे स्टेट् ज्ञानावस्था इति देर् इस् एन् अज्ञानावस्था वर्सस् ज्ञानावस्था दट् इस् दि मन्त्र यु नो So it categorizes like that yatra started, that is ajnanavastha. Now again yatra, followed by why, indeed, jnanavastha. So to this gentleman, asya, asya jnaninaha, to this gentleman, sarvam atmaiva abhut, all is atma. This is called sarvatma bhava, all is atma is sarvatma bhava. You see, if you say sarvatmani pritihi, means love on the one who is all, that is Ishvara. The love towards the one who is all, that is called bhakti. You see, in bhakti also there is sarvatma bhava. So, sarvatmani pritihi, that is bhakti. That sarvatma is indeed atma. One's own atma. That is jnana. Only language is different. Vastu is just the same. So, in love, there is no division. Only when there is no love, there is attachment, then you have division. In love, there is no division. Therefore, when you say love towards the sarvatma, then you are already merged in it. That is bhakti. And then, that sarvatma is my swarupa. You say that is jnana. So that is the only difference. The sarvatma bhava is the critical aspect of moksha. In Advaita Vedanta, Shankara points out many a time, moksha means sarvatma bhava. And all other descriptions of moksha are there, but essentially, moksha is sarvatma bhava. What I am includes all. Means we have to know a few things there. First of all, you should know that you are a being. People don't know that. People, they do not know that they are the being. Okay, limited, all right. Limited and truncated, but still a being. That's why the word human being is a good word. Every other word is a problem word. You may love it, and you may keep it for a while, but a day comes when you have to rise above that. So, and then you are a being. First, you have to know that you are a being. However limited you may be, however I am a being. Sometimes I am happy, sometimes I am unhappy, sometimes I feel wretched, sometimes I feel hilarious, but still I am a being. That is the starting point. Then I am a being, then what is this? This is the being. another mode of existence. You have to come there, you have to reach there. You cannot say Namarupa, you should not get stuck. If you are stuck with Namarupa, you cannot make any progress. Therefore, you have to move forward from Namarupa. And so this is all existence. What you call world is a mode of being. What you call I am or myself is a mode of being. Now that is the starting point. Now you have to investigate whether what I call myself, that being, includes all. Because everything is being. I am also being. Now, whether this being which I call myself, does it include only this body mind, that it does it include a lot more? So, in fact, it includes all. That is called Sarvatma Bhava. This is how we started. Yes, Sarvam Atmaiva Bhut. This is a very important statement, because that is the moksha and freedom. And freedom is what? Some special status we get later, suddenly we get it and then we will be in immense bliss, etc. True. All of that is true. I am not saying it is not. But you need not wait for that. You can become free now. You can become free. So why should you wait for that? Why not become free so that you can sleep happily tonight, you know? That is freedom. So now and here, become free. Love freedom. People should learn to love freedom. They don't love freedom. They love pleasures. They love names and forms. They love outward appearances. So they love the outer cloaks. They don't love freedom. So you should learn to love freedom. See, I met a friend. After 2 decades I met him. And he was wearing a very, very costly suit and boot and all that. Very powerful, very, very costly boot though. Of course it is there. So a suit and all that he was wearing. And a tie and all that. And he became an executive, whatever. And he is my buddy. So, after all usual questions are over, I ask him, what is all this? Then he told, you become a sannyasi, so you don't need, but we are grahasthas. We need it. Okay, you need it. I appreciate that. But the tie you have, you are having a tie. In India, can you imagine a tie? In India, here you know it is all right. And a suit and a boot, all that in India, okay, you are good, you are doing fine. Probably your profession needs. But below that dress, what is there? That you tell me. So already 50s, do you have diabetes? He said yes. What is this? Then why do you put such a powerful dress on the outside and inside the body is sick? He's having diabetes and he has BP, but he puts wonderful dress. Then I told him, why you became diabetic, shall I tell you? Because you started giving so much importance to the outward appearances and in the process started neglecting the real thing, therefore you became a diabetic. Do you exercise? No, I don't have time. That's why you became diabetic. You have time to put on all this dress and tie and all that, but you don't have time to do exercise so that you can keep diabetes away. People are crazy. They don't put the right priorities. So, anyway, I don't know why I said that. The point is, the Namarupa, you have to reject. And as long as you give importance to the Namarupa, like giving importance to the dress and the neglecting the physical health, you make the body sick and then put on costly clothes around the body, what a shameful thing it is. Because the costly clothes cannot hide you, at least to yourself, what is inside. Similarly, outwardly we are very Namarupa oriented, అండ్ ఇన్వర్ట్లీ వీ రిమైన్ ఇగ్నరెంట్ అజ్ఞాన. సో యూ హెవ్ టు మూవ్ ఫార్వర్డ్, యూ హెవ్ టు మూవ్ అవే ఫ్రమ్ నామరూప. లైక్ ఐ టెల్ యూ ది స్టెప్ వైజ్ మూవ్మెంట్ టువర్డ్స్ సర్వాత్మభావ, బికాస్ దిస్ ఈజ్ ది లాస్ట్ స్టేట్మెంట్ ఐఎమ్ డీలింగ్ విత్, దెర్ ఫర్ ఐ విల్ టెల్ యూ హౌ. సపోజ్ హీర్ ఈజ్ ఎ పర్సన్, హీ థింక్స్ అబౌట్ హిమ్సెల్ఫ్, హీ స్పీక్స్ అబౌట్ హిమ్సెల్ఫ్ ఓన్లీ, అండ్ హీ యాక్ట్స్ ఫర్ హిమ్సెల్ఫ్ ఓన్లీ. సో టోటల్లీ ఐడెంటిఫైడ్ విత్ ది బాడీ, అండ్ నౌ ద ఫ్యామిలీ ఈజ్ దేర్ టు సర్వ్ హిమ్, అండ్ ది సొసైటీ ఈజ్ ఆల్సో దేర్ టు సర్వ్ హిమ్. సో ఎక్స్ట్రీమ్ సెల్ఫిష్నెస్, అండ్ సెల్ఫిష్నెస్ ఆల్సో ఐడెంటిఫైడ్ విత్ ది బాడీ, టోటల్ ఐడెంటిఫికేషన్. సచ్ ఎ పర్సన్ ఈజ్ వెరీ యాక్టివ్. జనరల్లీ దీస్ వెరీ సెల్ఫిష్ పీపుల్ ఆర్ వెరీ యాక్టివ్. నాట్ సో సెల్ఫిష్ పర్సన్ కుడ్ బి లెస్ యాక్టివ్, బట్ వెరీ సెల్ఫిష్ పీపుల్ ఆర్ వెరీ యాక్టివ్ బికాస్ ద సెల్ఫిష్నెస్ డ్రైవ్స్ దెమ్. సో ద ఈగో అండ్ ది సెల్ఫిష్నెస్ అండ్ ఇగ్నరెన్స్ హ్యాజ్ ఎ పికూలియర్ ఎనర్జీ విచ్ సత్వగుణ డజంట్ హ్యావ్. యూ షుడ్ నో దాట్ ఎ సాత్విక్ పర్సన్ విల్ రిమైన్ వెరీ క్వాయట్ అండ్ యూ మే ఎండ్ అప్ బిలీవింగ్ దట్ హీ ఈజ్ ఎ డల్ పర్సన్. సో వెరాజ్ దిస్ సెల్ఫిష్ పీపుల్, రాజసిక్ పీపుల్, దే హ్యావ్ ఎ పిక్యులర్ ఎనర్జీ, దేర్ ఇగ్నరెన్స్ హ్యాజ్ ఎ పిక్యులర్ ఎనర్జీ. ఎనీవే, సో హీ ఈజ్ కంపేర్డ్ విత్ ఎ స్పిండిల్. యు నో స్పిండిల్, ద స్పిండిల్ వీ యూస్ టు ప్లే ఇన్ ది చైల్డ్హుడ్ లైక్ దాట్. అండ్ నవడేస్ దే టాయ్ షాప్స్ హ్యావ్ గాట్ వెరీ గుడ్ స్పిండిల్స్. ఐ హ్యావ్ సీన్ విత్ ఎ కిడ్, అండ్ ఇన్ అవర్ టైమ్స్ ఇట్ వాజ్ ఎ వెరీ ఓల్డ్ ఫ్యాషన్డ్ స్పిండిల్ అండ్ ఆల్ దాట్. అండ్ సో దిస్ స్పిండిల్ ఇట్స్ ఎ టాప్, యా వీ డోంట్ కాల్ ఇట్ స్పిండిల్, బట్ మై ఫ్రెండ్ సేస్ యూ కెన్ కాల్ ఇట్ స్పిండిల్ ఆల్సో, రైట్? యా, థ్యాంక్ యూ డేవిడ్. సో టాప్, టాప్ ఇట్ ఈస్. సో దిస్ టాప్, స్పిన్నింగ్ టాప్ యూ హ్యావ్ టు సే, అదర్వైజ్ టాప్ మీన్స్ వాట్ టాప్ ఇస్ ఇన్ ది టాప్. సో ద స్పిన్నింగ్ టాప్ ఇట్ స్పిన్స్ అండ్ స్పిన్స్ గైరేటరీ మోషన్, బట్ ఇట్ ఈస్ స్పిన్నింగ్ అరౌండ్ ఇట్ సెల్ఫ్ ఓన్లీ. All its movement and activity is centered around itself, right? Centered in itself. This is how the human being starts his life. Now he starts expanding. What is Atma? This is Atma. You see me? This is Atma. Take a photograph and keep it also. This is the Atma. Okay. Then he starts expanding. Now he expands. So my family is myself. Shankara says, పుత్రో పుత్ర సకల అహం సకల, పుత్రో వికల అహం వికల. ఐడెంటిఫికేషన్ విత్ ది ఫ్యామిలీ అండ్ ఇన్ అదర్ ప్లేస్ హీ సేస్ భార్యా సకల అహం సకల, హీ సేస్ దట్ ఆల్సో. సో ఎనీవే, ది ఐడెంటిఫికేషన్ విత్ ది ఫ్యామిలీ, హీఈస్ విల్లింగ్ టు వర్క్ ఆల్ హిస్ లైఫ్ ఫర్ ది వెల్ఫేర్ ఆఫ్ ది ఫ్యామిలీ. సో నౌ ది ఆత్మా హ్యాజ్ ఎక్స్పాండెడ్ to cover the family. But anything outside the family is not covered. Suppose sometimes the parents are outside the family, then they are also left outside only. Sometimes it happens like that. Brother is not included, parents are not included, only wife and children, nuclear family. So, but still an expansion. So this is called a race horse man. Not a spindle man, a race horse. The race horse will be going round and round and round, you know, but still somewhat better. And then the Atma further expands. And now he says, my caste, India. In India, caste societies constitute the major organized groups. Because every society is registered. So the registration of the society act is there. And according to that, you have to register the society. There is another kind of registration called a trust. So you may register as society or you may register as a trust. And 50% of the societies and trusts registered in India, they are based on one or the other caste. There are 3,000 castes. And it's a caste-ridden society. Society is like that. Nowadays, somewhat better. means in city state is urbanization has an effect, has a leveling effect, like flat earth, they say, you know. Thomas Friedman says flat earth. So similarly, the caste divisions are also flattened somewhat. And but still, so caste, Noir society, Kamma society, Reddy's hostel. Only Reddy's will be there in that hostel. No other caste will be allowed. Reddy's hostel. Kshatriya Chowltry. Kshatriyas will be there. Like that. So, but, and there are people who are very devoted to that work. Somebody should be there. The registration, etc. is not easy. And then they build a building, it has a building, and secretary, etc. They devote all their energy for that work. So they identify with the caste. And this person is traveling in the bus. He is the secretary of the Kamma society, suppose. It need not be Kamma, it can be anything, but Kamma society secretary. And then somebody comes and sits. Then he doesn't speak. In India, we don't believe in all this high and all that. We are with ourselves. So then he comes and sits. He also comes and sits. This man is a caste guy, you know. He asks, how are you? What is your good name? Where are you going? I am going to so-and-so. Then slowly after 3-4 questions, he will ask, what caste? Because until he knows that caste, his stomach cannot so stomach pain will come. So he says, Kamma. Kamma? Which, what town? Are you a member of our society? Why not become a member? Already he takes the receipt book. So this is how the Atma is now expanded to include all Kamma. Kamma is a criminal. Sometimes in India, when a criminal is arrested, suppose that criminal belongs to our caste, then do dharna. He should be released. Can you believe it? They do dharma. He should not be arrested because he is our guy. Arey, he is arrested while taking bribe. Everybody is taking bribe. Only why our caste man only should be arrested? Release him. So the expansion of the self. Even if he is a criminal, he is our caste man. Therefore, he is the Atma. And outside the caste barrier, some wonderful rishi is there. He is not our caste man. Therefore, we don't care for him. He is the other. So, but the self expanded. Such people are called trade wind men. The trade wind, it goes around half of the globe. So these people have expanded like that. And then there is another person. He is the nationalist. Nationalism. Our nation. Nowadays, nationalism is not so fanatical because of the globalization and all that, flat earth policies and all that. You have to know, if you know the Second World War history of Europe, you will understand what is nationalism. Nationalism was at its zenith. So much so, nationalism is the same as fascism. Fascism. Mussolini, etc., they were fascists. But fascism is identical with nationalism. Very powerful nationalists. Hitler was like that. And then even Romanians of those days, they were very strong nationalists. So Finnish people, all small groups have become very powerful nationalists. And therefore, the war went on based on the principles of nationalism. Anyway, these nationalists, they are willing to give their life to the nation because they identify with the entire nation. And if the other person is not of that nation, he is another nation, fie upon him. So he is enemy. He may be a person whom you do not even know. You are looking at him for the very first time, but still he is enemy. Another person you are looking first time, still he is myself, Atma. This is nationalism. The Atma is expanded to include the entire nation. But outside the nation, it is concave, you know. Outside the concavity, it is non-self. But still, lot of expansion. Such people are called moon men. Like moon goes round the earth. Lot of expansion. అండ్ దెన్ కమ్స్ ద వసుధైవ కుటుంబకం. దిస్ ఈజ్ అవర్ రిషీస్. ద ఎంటైర్ యూనివర్స్ ఈజ్ వన్ ఫ్యామిలీ. ఐ ఎమ్ ఎ హ్యూమన్ బీయింగ్. దట్ ఈస్ ద నెక్స్ట్ స్టేజ్. సో ఎవ్రీ హ్యూమన్ బీయింగ్ ఈజ్ ఆత్మ. ఆత్మా ఇంక్లూడ్స్ ఆల్ హ్యుమానిటీ. అండ్ దెన్ ఆత్మా ఇంక్లూడ్స్ ఆల్ లైఫ్, నాట్ ఓన్లీ హ్యుమానిటీ. హ్యూమన్స్ ఆర్ నాట్ ది ఓన్లీ లివింగ్ బీయింగ్స్. ఆత్మా ఇంక్లూడ్స్ ఆల్ లైఫ్. అండ్ దెన్ ఆత్మా ఇంక్లూడ్స్ ఆల్ ఎగ్జిస్టెన్స్. సచ్ పీపుల్ ఆర్ లైక్ ద సన్ మెన్. సన్ మెన్, సన్ డజంట్ గో రౌండ్ ఎనీథింగ్. సన్ ట్రావెల్స్ ఇన్ ది స్ట్రైట్ లైన్. Sun travels in the straight line in the galaxy. I don't know what is the meaning of zodiac and all that. I am not very sure about it. I have to understand it. I don't know it. I admit my ignorance. But this much I know. Sun travels in a straight line in the galaxy. Sun travels elliptical orbit? Oh. Let us take sun travel. Ellipses are particular, a big ellipse, therefore it looks like a straight line. So sun travels in a straight line. And that is our example. That means if it is a straight line, sun is not concave to anything to exclude, sun is not convex to anything to include. Sun neither includes nor excludes. Similarly, a jnani, he doesn't include some existence as his own and the rest, not myself. He doesn't exclude anything, he doesn't include anything. In fact, he includes everything. So that is the sarvam atmaiva bhut. Means all existence is myself. These are the jnanis. So that way, I gave these steps because a practical method I presented before you. This is how you have to expand and expand and expand. You should not restrict your being to the physical body. You should expand to the family. And then you should expand to the community, further expand to the nation, and further expand to the entire humanity, and then expand to all life, and then expand to living and non-living, including all. Sarvam atmai vabhut. So, that is the mantra. The same thing is there in Gita. Yasya sarvani bhutani. ఆత్మైవాభూత్ విజానత తస్య కో మోహ కశోక ఏకత్వమనుపశ్యత. దిస్ ఈస్ ఫ్రమ్ కేనోపనిషత్. సారీ, ఈశావాస్యోపనిషత్, ఈశావాస్యోపనిషత్. అండ్ లైక్ దట్ ఈవెన్ ఇన్ గీత ఆల్సో ఎస్టు సర్వాణి భూతాన్ని లైక్ దట్ దెర్ ఈజ్ ఎ వెర్స్ ఇన్ ది 6th అధ్యాయ. సేమ్ స్పిరిట్. సో ఐ ఆమ్ ది ఆత్మ విచ్ ఇంక్లూడ్స్ ఆల్ ఎగ్జిస్టెన్స్. విచ్ ఇంక్లూడ్స్ ఆల్ ఎగ్జిస్టెన్స్. So, you have to go to that level. I will present it slightly in a different way and then move to the Bhashyam. It is like this. You see, I am a Punjabi, you are a Madrasi. We are different. But suppose you ignore the region and take Indian, Indianness, then we are same. I am an Indian, you are an American. We are different. But you take humanness, then we are same. We are same. I am a human, and that is an animal. A cow is an animal. We are different. But if you take livingness, life, same life in both bodies, then if you identify with the life instead of identifying with a shape, then we are one life. We are not two different lives. We are one life, two different bodies, but one life. Where is your identification? That is important. We are one life. Okay, I am a living being and here is a stone. We are different. No, you are a being. Stone is also a being. As being, we are one. So, this is how you have to move in that direction. Unfortunately, while studying Vedanta, if you move in the opposite direction, you are not doing anything meaningful. Study of Vedanta is not about reciting a few sentences and verses here and there. ఇట్ ఈస్ ది స్టడీ ఆఫ్ ది బుక్ ఆఫ్ లైఫ్ అండ్ దేర్ ఫార్ సర్వాత్మభావ ఇస్ ది హయ్యెస్ట్ గోల్ దట్ ఈస్ ది మోక్ష అండ్ ఎవ్రీ స్టెప్ దట్ యు టేక్ మస్ట్ టేక్ యూ 1 inch నియరర్ టు సర్వాత్మభావ యు షుడ్ ఎక్స్పాండ్ యువర్ బీయింగ్ యు ఆర్ ది బీయింగ్ ఫస్ట్ అండర్స్టాండ్ యు ఆర్ ది బీయింగ్ and then recognize the barriers that you have created around that being and the concavity you have created for yourself around that being and then start pushing it outer and outer you remove this barrier and then you find another barrier is there remove that then you will find another barrier is there remove that a stage comes when there is no barrier that is called sarvatma bhava that is moksha in doing this every time you demolish a barrier you find freshness of freedom it is very enjoyable and it is very fresh very lightening to the heart and you feel so light and so this is the sarvatma bhava and once you have sarvatma bhava tat kena kam jigret It is all one awareness. And this awareness, he doesn't know. This I was trying to say, I love it myself. I love the things that I say. The awareness doesn't know. You know why it doesn't know? To know, you should have memory. The mind knows. The mind knows what it knows. The mind knows its own folly. And then gives a name to it and makes it the other, gives a label to it as the other. And so mind knows, awareness which is beyond the knower and the known and also the knowing the pramana in between. So awareness which is beyond the triputi, that awareness, it is the being. It is the being shining as the knowing. And the knowing having its glory in being, that is what it is. He doesn't know. He doesn't know at all. Because knowing is a mechanism. It is beyond all such mechanisms. Knowing is a movement. It is beyond all movement. It is knowing, pure knowing, which does not know, which is unself-conscious being it is. A knowing which does not know is the being which is unself-conscious. So that is the awareness. In that pure Atma, kaha kena kam jigret? Who smells what with what? Means the division triputi is absent. It is not a question. It is akshepa. It is a negation. Negation in the form of a question. That is called akshepaha. So that is the language, the beauty of language, you know. Akshepa means, so will you go to New York? Who will go to New York now in this weather? Suppose you say, is it a question? It is not a question. It is an assertion. It is a negation. It just means nobody will go to New York in this weather. That is the meaning of it. Similarly here, there is no karta. Kaha jigret, no karta. Kena jigret, no karana. Kam jigret, no karma. And what do you mean by jigret? No pramana. No movement of the, which is called pramana. Nos is the pramana, you know. So, all the divisions are eliminated. We'll see further. Yatra tu brahma vidyaya avidyanasham upagamita tatra atma vyatirekena anyasya abhavaha. We have seen that much. నెక్స్ట్ యత్ర వా అస్యాం బ్రహ్మవిదః సర్వం నామరూపాది ఆత్మన్యేవ ప్రవిలాపితం ఆత్మైవ సంవృత్తం సో యత్ర మీన్స్ యస్మిన్ కాలే యస్యాం అవస్థాయాం ఇన్ విచ్ అవస్థ Asya Brahmavidaha, that Asya is there in the mantra. Asya means to this Brahmavid, one who knows the Brahman. as his own swarupa, to him sarvam atmaiva samvruttam, all became atma. Means all existence is included in atma. So you see, I tell you, the difference between a jnani and a jnani is very clear. You see, outwardly jnani and ajnani look just the same. In fact, there was a question in the satsang, I described it. Outwardly, there will be no difference whatsoever. In fact, by outward appearance, you cannot know a jnani or an ajnani. An ajnani you can know, but a jnani you cannot know. Ajnani's ajnana chinha, the symbol, signals are always there. But a jnani you cannot know. Oh, he is a jnani. By looking at him, you cannot say. Because a jnani may look in any possible way. And therefore, outwardly, there is not much difference between a jnani and a jnani. On the surface, they look alike. But in depth, there is nothing common between a jnani and an ajnani. So, there is so much difference inwardly. You see, an ajnani, he knows himself. Ajnani knows himself. How he knows, what is the pramana for him? Through mind and senses. That is his pramana. So, I am a man, I am a woman, I am Indian, I am tall, I am short, I am beautiful, I am old, middle-aged. How do you know all these things? You are saying, I gave so many words. You look at yourself, all this. What is the means of cognition or knowing to say all these things? There must be some pramana. What is the pramana? Mind and senses. That is the pramana. Right? I am unhappy. How do you know? Yeah, I know my mind is unhappy and I am the mind. Mind is the pramana. Mind is the pramana. Senses are the pramana. That is, they are the pramana. And so, through mind you know yourself. An ajnani knows oneself through mind and through senses. And therefore, whatever the senses suggest that I am, that is ajnani. Whatever the mind suggests that I am, you see, people say, I am unlucky. Why you are unlucky? How do you know that you are unlucky? Yeah, I know. How do you know? The mind suggests that I am unlucky. This mind suggests to everybody that you are unlucky. Everybody feels that he is unlucky. Can you believe it? Everybody feels that he is unlucky. Therefore, so we know ourselves through, but through the senses and the mind. And you see, people have about themselves atma. Atma means oneself. So what they think of, what an ajnani thinks of oneself is nothing but a mere idea. He has an idea. Like aham kshatriyaha. What is that? It is a mere idea. And all these ideas people have about themselves are all mediocre, second-hand, and they are entirely based on hearsay. These are the ideas that we have about ourselves. Therefore, I would put it in a nutshell. When you say you know yourself, it is through senses, it is through the mind, and it is what you know about yourself is mediocre, hearsay, and second-hand. And you see, you see something, and based on that, you judge yourself or you assess yourself, I am rich, I am poor, like that. Based on the outward things, we judge ourselves. Whereas a jnani will never understand himself based on the mind and the senses. That's why he is called jnani. He may see as we see, he may hear as we hear, he may taste as we taste, and he also feels hunger and thirst like every ajnani. And when he is sick, the body becomes sick. When the body is sick, he also takes medicine and all that. But other than that, when it comes to awareness of oneself, there is an immense distance between an ajnani and a jnani. A jnani is like a cinema screen. So he doesn't identify with anything, like cinema screen doesn't identify with anything that appears on it. So the cinema screen remains clear and empty. After 3 hours cinema show, so the screen remains clear and empty. The pictures pass over it and disappear. And the pictures, as they disappear, they leave the screen just as clear and empty as before. The jnani is like that. All events happen and they appear and disappear. He remains like the screen, clear and empty, pure awareness, not burdened by self-identifications based on the pictures that pass through on the screen. So that is how a jnani is. So the pictures cannot affect the screen in any possible way. And also the screen does not affect the pictures. You should know that the screen doesn't affect the pictures. It just leaves them alone. You see, I will tell you one thumb rule. In a jnani's vision or in a jnani's life, nothing ever goes wrong. That is what a jnani's life is. Nothing ever goes wrong. Because something has gone wrong only when you resist it. Only when you expect something that did not happen, therefore it is wrong. You desire something, something did not happen, therefore it is wrong. Whereas a jnani is clear and empty. No desire, no fear. So when there is no desire and there is no fear, how can anything go wrong for a jnani? That is how a jnani is. And so, he just doesn't judge himself based on Namarupa. All Namarupa he devours. And Sarvan Namarupadi Atmanyeva Pravilapitam. You see, Namarupa Pravilapitam means, you have to understand, there is always a negation there. Without negation, you cannot solve anything. Because otherwise what happens, the Namarupa are all made a bundle and they are taken in. So a bundle of Namarupa are sitting inside. And now they will come out later. It is not like that. So Namarupa is unreal. So how do you resolve or pravilapanam, they say. How do you do pravilapanam? The Sanskrit word it is. So how do you pravilapanam? It is like sarpa resolved in the rajju. That is how you do. You see the false as the false, and the false dissolves. That is the pravilapanam. So you should be very clear about it. Otherwise what happens, you know, jnani resolves, he eats away all namarupas. Now he must be having all of them in himself. In himself means in the body they will be there, or in the mind they will be there, or in the atma they will be there. So now atma they will be there, let us say. And then from atma they will come back again. If this serpent, you see what happened is, this person went into the room and he saw a serpent. And he jumped and came out. And he doesn't want that serpent to come out and hurt anybody, therefore he locked that room. And he doesn't want anybody to go into that room also, because he may be bitten by this serpent. Therefore, he locked that room. Now, that serpent, in spite of locking that room and all that serpent will haunt him, right? And he has gone to his friend's home and slept elsewhere. But that serpent did not go away. He did not, there is no pravilapanam. How can he do pravilapanam of that serpent? There is only one way. He has to carefully open the door, even suspiciously, take a good light, powerful battery light in his hand, and throw the light into that room, and see, oho, it is Rajju. Now the serpent is Pravilapitam. That is the only Pravilapanam. Therefore, for a jnani, all Namarupa are unreal, and so now they are Pravilapitam. ఆత్మైవ సంవృత్తం. నౌ వాట్ హ్యాపన్ టు ది సర్ప ప్రవిలాపితం ఇన్ ది రజ్జు? అండ్ సో వెన్ ది సర్ప ఇస్ ప్రవిలాపితం ఇన్ ది రజ్జు, నౌ దట్ రజ్జు, ఇట్ ఈస్ రజ్జు ప్లస్ ప్రవిలాపిత సర్పెంట్? నో, ఇట్ ఈస్ రజ్జు ఓన్లీ. హౌ మచ్ రజ్జు? వాట్ ఎవర్ రజ్జు వస్తే ద సేమ్ రజ్జు. బట్ వాట్ అబౌట్ ప్రవిలాపిత సర్పెంట్? యు ఆర్ నాట్ రిజాల్వింగ్ ఎనీథింగ్ రియల్ దేర్. ఇట్ ఈస్ జస్ట్ సీయింగ్ ది అన్రియల్ యాజ్ ది అన్రియల్. దట్ ఈస్ కాల్డ్ ప్రవిలాపితం. దేర్ ఫార్ ఆత్మైవ సంవృత్తం. ది సర్ప హ్యాస్ నౌ బికమ్ రజ్జు ఇట్ సెల్ఫ్, నథింగ్ మోర్ నథింగ్ లెస్. సిమిలర్లీ ఆల్ ఎగ్జిస్టెన్స్ హ్యాస్ బికమ్ ఆత్మా. యత్ర ఏవం ఆత్మైవాభూత్ తత్ర తత్ తత్ర కేన కరణేన కం ఘాతవ్యం కో జిఘ్రేత్ తథా పశ్యేత్ విజానీయాత్. సో వెన్ ఎవ్రీథింగ్ హ్యాస్ బికమ్ ఆత్మ, ఎత్ర ఏవం ఆత్మైవాభూత్. ఎత్ర మీన్స్ విద్యావస్థాయాం, ఎస్మిన్ ఇన్ విచ్ స్టేట్ ఆఫ్ నాలెడ్జ్. ఏవం ఇన్ ది వే డిస్క్రైబ్డ్ ఆత్మైవ అభూత్ సర్వం. ఎవ్రీథింగ్ హ్యాస్ బికమ్ ఆత్మ మీన్స్ ఎవ్రీథింగ్ ఈజ్ రిజాల్వ్డ్ ఇన్ ఆత్మ. దేర్ ఫార్ ఎర్లియర్ ఐ వాస్ థింకింగ్ దట్ ఘట జ్ఞానం ఈజ్ డిఫరెంట్, ఘట ఈజ్ డిఫరెంట్. నవ్ ఐ నో దెర్ ఈజ్ నో ఘట అదర్ దాన్ ఘట జ్ఞానం. జ్ఞేయాభిన్న జ్ఞాన వీ డోంట్ యాక్సెప్ట్. జ్ఞానభిన్న జ్ఞేయం వీ డోంట్ యాక్సెప్ట్. వేదాంతిన్స్ డోంట్ యాక్సెప్ట్ జ్ఞానభిన్నం జ్ఞేయం. సో జ్ఞాన ఈజ్ ఇన్సైడ్, జ్ఞేయం ఈజ్ అవుట్ సైడ్, వీ డోంట్ యాక్సెప్ట్ ఇట్. సో వెన్ జ్ఞానభిన్న జ్ఞేయం ఈజ్ నాట్ యాక్సెప్టెడ్, జ్ఞేయం ఈజ్ ప్రవిలాపితం ఇన్ ది జ్ఞాన. అండ్ దట్ జ్ఞాన అన్డిఫరెన్షియేటెడ్ ప్యూర్ అవేర్నెస్. సో దట్ జ్ఞాన విచ్ డజంట్ స్ప్లిట్ ఇన్ టు జ్ఞాత అండ్ జ్ఞేయ, సో దట్ ప్యూర్ జ్ఞాన విచ్ డజంట్ నో ఎనీథింగ్ విచ్ జస్ట్ రిమైన్స్ యాజ్ జ్ఞప్తి భావరూప జ్ఞప్తి, దట్ జ్ఞాన దట్ ఈస్ ది ఆత్మ. అండ్ ఇన్ దట్ వెన్ సో హీ హ్యాస్ బికమ్ లైక్ దాట్, సో దెర్ ఇస్ నో డివిజన్ నౌ. వెన్ దెర్ ఇస్ నో డివిజన్, కేన కరణైన కం ఘాతవ్యం కో జిఘ్రేత్. సో కరణ ఈజ్ నా, సో నౌ ఘట, ఘట ఈజ్ నో డిఫరెంట్ ఫ్రమ్ జ్ఞాన. దెన్ ఐ సైట్, వాట్ యూ కాల్ ఐ సైట్, ఈజ్ ఇట్ నాట్ జ్ఞానం? జ్ఞానం ఓన్లీ కాల్డ్ ఐ సైట్, రైట్? జ్ఞానం ఓన్లీ కాల్డ్ పవర్ ఆఫ్ హియరింగ్. బికాజ్ వెన్ జ్ఞానం కమ్స్ అవుట్ ఆఫ్ ది ఐస్, ఇట్ గెట్స్ రూపాస్. ఇట్ కమ్స్ అవుట్ ఆఫ్ ది ఇయర్స్ జ్ఞానం, ఇట్ ఇల్యూమినేట్స్ శబ్ద. దెర్ఫోర్ ఇట్ ఈజ్ ఆల్ జ్ఞానం ఓన్లీ. ది కరణం ఈజ్ ఆల్సో జ్ఞానం. వాట్ ఈజ్ మైండ్? కాగ్నిషన్, కాగ్నిటివ్ ఇన్స్ట్రుమెంట్. కాగ్నిటివ్ ఇన్స్ట్రుమెంట్స్ మీన్స్ ఈజ్ ఇట్ మేడ్ ఆఫ్ సమ్ ఐరన్ అండ్ స్టీల్ ఆర్ గోల్డ్ ఆర్ సిల్వర్? ఇట్ ఈజ్ జ్ఞానం ఓన్లీ. అండ్ హూ ఈజ్ ది జ్ఞాత? జ్ఞానం ఓన్లీ. సర్వం జ్ఞానమయం, జ్ఞానం అండ్ నథింగ్ ఎల్స్. డివిజన్ ఇన్ జ్ఞానం ఈజ్ కాజ్డ్ బై ద మైండ్. అండ్ దేర్ ఫార్ వెన్ దిస్ ఈజ్ అండర్స్టూడ్ ద డివిజన్ లైక్ కర్త కరణ కేన కరణేన కం ఘాతవ్యం కర్మ కో జిఘ్రేత్ కహ కర్త అండ్ జిఘ్రేత్ మీన్స్ ద క్రియా అని క్రియాఫలం. ఆల్ ఆఫ్ దట్ ఈస్ రిజాల్వ్డ్ ఇన్ వన్ ఆత్మస్వరూప. ఆల్ ఆఫ్ దెమ్ ఆర్ నామరూప, ఆల్ ఆఫ్ దెమ్. సో వాట్ యు కాల్ కర్త ఈజ్ అ నామరూప. యు సీ నేమ్ అండ్ ఫామ్, వాట్ యు కాల్ నాలెడ్జ్, వాట్ యు కాల్ నాలెడ్జ్ ఈజ్ నథింగ్ బట్ ఎ నేమ్. దట్స్ వై వెన్ సనత్ కుమార్ వాస్ టోల్డ్ బై నారద మహర్షి దట్ హీ న్యూ దిస్ హీ న్యూ దాట్ హీ న్యూ ద ఋగ్వేద యజుర్వేద, సో 64 నేమ్స్ హీ టోల్డ్ ఆల్ దీస్ విద్యాస్ ఐ నో. దెన్ సనత్ కుమార్ అటెడ్ నామై వైతత్, ఆల్ దిస్ ఈజ్ నామ. వాట్ యూ కాల్ నాలెడ్జ్ ఈజ్ ఎ నేమ్. సో ఐ నో ఫ్లవర్, నాలెడ్జ్ ఆఫ్ ది ఫ్లవర్. వాట్ ఈజ్ ది నాలెడ్జ్ ఆఫ్ ది ఫ్లవర్? ఇట్ ఈస్ జస్ట్ ఎ నేమ్. నాలెడ్జ్ ఆఫ్ ది ఫ్లవర్ ఈజ్ ఎ నేమ్. knowledge of this is a name, knowledge of that is a name. What you call knowledge is just a name, nothing more to it. Therefore, all this is resolved in pure awareness. Sarvatrahi karaka sadhya kriya ataha karaka bhave anupapattihi kriyayah. In all situations, sarvatra, when there is a kriya, this kriya is accomplished by karakas. Karaka sadhya kriya. An action or an activity is indeed put in place by karakas. Karta will be there, karana will be there, and then karma will be there. Like Ramaha, Ravanam, Ahanat. So that Ahanat kriya. So karta must be there, karma must be there. If Rama is not there, no kriya. If Ravana is not there, no kriya. If Bana is not there, no kriya. So, all kriya is karaka sadhya. Now, what happened is in the life of a jnani, all these karakas are resolved. Shankara gave a name to it, upamardhanam. Upamardhanam is an interesting word. They make chutney. That is called upamardhanam. So take a dozen items. You have to see them making chutney. Coconut chutney they make. You have to see them making it. So what they do? First they coconut pieces into the mortar and pestle. So go round and round. And so now coconut pieces have become a paste. Now the roasted things, a dozen things will be there. One. Another. Chilies. Salt. Everything is added and upamardhanam. That is the word. Shankara from Kerala, you know, some chutney word it is. And so he took it from there. And therefore, karta is gone. Karma gone. Karana gone. And then sampradana gone. Apadana gone. Adhara gone. Kriya gone. Kriya phalam gone. Everything is devoured. Now there can be no kriya. Kriya is not possible. Because kriya becomes possible only when there are karakas. And now there is no karaka at all. Karaka bhave kriyayaha anupapattihi. In the absence of karakas, kriya becomes meaningless. Kriya bhave cha phala bhavaha. When kriya is not there, phala is not there. So bhokta will not be there, phala will not be there. None of these things will be there. All of this is our imagination. I am the karta, this is the kriya, phala will come later and I will enjoy it. All of this is imagination. You see, you have done so many kriyas and then you have enjoyed so many phalas. Kaha ho bhai? Where are you? So, it is a time to pause and look, I tell you. So, when kriya is not possible, because all karakas are resolved, then phala is not possible. Tasmad avidyameva satyam kriya karaka phalavyavaharaha na brahma vidaha. So, therefore, as long as avidya is there, tasmat avidyameva satyam. Tasmat means kriyakaraka phalavyavaharasya avidyakatvat. Kriyakaraka phala vyavahara it is. There is a thing called vyavahara. So this is the vyavahara. Vyavahara means you are a karta. Now you have vyavahara. And in that vyavahara you act. When you act upon something, karma. And you act with something, even if that something is hand or whatever. Or you go and hit your head to that, then head becomes a karana. If you do with hand, hand becomes a karana. Like that, the adhara, some place will be adhara. So all karakas are there. When you are karta, all karakas are there. This is the vyavahara. Don't think that vyavahara means some special thing. This is the vyavahara. You are the karta. You are sleeping. Is there a vyavahara? No. You wake up, then vyavahara begins. వ్యవహార సపోజ్ యూ ఆర్ స్టాండింగ్ బిఫోర్ ది సన్, సన్ ఈజ్ నాట్ రెస్పాన్సిబుల్ ఫర్ ది వ్యవహార. సన్ టోల్డ్ యూ టు డూ వ్యవహార? నో, సన్ ఈజ్ నాట్ రెస్పాన్సిబుల్ ఫర్ ది వ్యవహార. యు ఆర్ ది కర్త అండ్ దేర్ ఫార్ యూ బిగిన్ ది వ్యవహార. సపోజ్ యు ఆర్ పెర్ఫార్మింగ్ పూజ, వై ఆర్ యూ పెర్ఫార్మింగ్ పూజ? నాట్ బికాస్ గాడ్ ఈజ్ దేర్ దేర్ ఫార్ ఐఎమ్ పెర్ఫార్మింగ్ పూజ. ఇజ్ ఇట్ సో? ఇట్ మే అపియర్ లైక్ దాట్. యు ఆర్ కర్త, దేర్ ఫార్ యు ఆర్ పెర్ఫార్మింగ్ పూజ. యు ఆర్ కర్త, దేర్ ఫార్ యు ఆర్ డూయింగ్ దిస్ యాక్షన్ దట్ యాక్షన్. దేర్ ఫార్ వ్యవహార డజంట్ హ్యాపెన్, ఇట్ ఈజ్ నాట్ మేడ్ టు హ్యాపెన్ బై ది వరల్డ్. ఇట్ ఈజ్ మేడ్ టు హ్యాపెన్ బై యువర్ ఓన్ అస్యూమింగ్ యువర్ సెల్ఫ్ యాజ్ ఎ కర్త. దేర్ ఫార్ దిస్ ఈజ్ ది వ్యవహార అండ్ వీఆర్ ఎగ్జామినింగ్ దిస్ వ్యవహార వెదర్ ఇట్ ఈస్ రియల్ ఆర్ నాట్ అండ్ వీఆర్ కంక్లూడింగ్ ఇట్ ఈస్ నాట్ రియల్. Then shall I stop all work? No, if you stop all work, then still you are karta. So you don't stop all work. You don't do, you realize that you are a karta. Knowledge it is. Knowledge. You realize that you are a karta. In that realization, the natural thing happens naturally. And therefore, when there is no karanas, there is no karakas, karana like karakas, and there is no phala, that is the vyavahara. Another aspect of the vyavahara. How? I am bhokta, therefore I want phalam. That's why when Sri Krishna told, karma phala tyagam kuru yatatmavan, you pay attention, be focused, single pointed mind you have, and then give up the karma phala. కర్మఫల త్యాగం మీన్స్ వాట్ భయ్? వాట్ డస్ ఇట్ మీన్? ఇట్ మీన్స్ గివింగ్ అప్ కర్మఫల. యు గివ్ అప్ కర్మఫల. వెన్ హీ సెడ్ దాట్ యు డూ ఇట్, 50% ఆఫ్ వ్యవహార ఇస్ గాన్. బికాస్ భోక్త కర్మఫలానుభవ, దట్ ఈస్ ది వ్యవహార అండ్ దట్ ఈస్ గాన్. అండ్ దెన్ క్రియా కర్తాకారక వ్యవహార ఆల్సో విల్ రిజాల్వ్. దేర్ ఫోర్ ఫర్ ఎ జ్ఞాని దేర్ ఈజ్ నో వ్యవహార. Why there is no vyavahara? He says, atmatva deva sarvasya na atmavyatirekena karakam kriyaphalam va asti. Because everything is atma. Sarvasya atmatva deva. Everything means kartru karana deha. Karta is atma. Karana is atma. Karma is atma. Brahmarpanam brahmahavihi. You know that. You see, sometimes what happens, when we say things routinely and nonchalantly, when you say it routinely, we miss the significance. Today morning in meditation I wanted to suggest, but I held back. I really wanted to suggest. You know what? Don't say Ramanama mechanically. Don't say it. You wait. If you don't have the focus of mind, if you don't have the feeling, don't say it. Keep it aside. Because that is the ultimate vajrayudha for you. It is the ultimate weapon for you to handle this samsara. So at least safeguard it. Don't use it in a wrong way. So that when everything else fails, you become desperate, then you can fall back upon that. Now you take that Ramanama and then take a harmonium and all that and do some orchestra out of it and say it in a mechanical way 1,000 times and then make that also mechanical and routine, then you are left with nothing. So, therefore, for God's sake, keep Ramanama aside. Don't say it till you really, really feel the depth of feeling of love. I wanted to say this. But then it ends up as if I am saying, don't say Ramanama. That's why I did not say it. Then I could have kept quiet, but now I said it. So this is how it goes on. Anyway, so atmavyatirekena, karakam is not there, kriyaphalam is not there. You see, what you call karana is atma. Pashyamschakshuhu. Atma alone appears as chakshuhu. Atma is the origin of life because of which there is a hand. what you call hand is atma. You see, what you call hand is the physical thing hand? No? The life is hand. And then life is hand. Life's origin is hand, which is atma. And therefore, all karana is atma. Place, adhara. What is the place? It's a space. What is space? It's a mental category. And what is mind? It's a ripple in the awareness. So what happened to your space? What happened to your time? Without time, where is karma? Where is action? Without time. And time is a mental category. And its mind is a ripple in the awareness. So everything is atma. Other than atma, there is nothing else. Therefore, kriya phalam is also not there. Nacha anatma san sarvamatmaiva bhavati kasya chit. You see, this flower is anatma, the world is anatma, swargaloka is anatma, the distance means anatma, not so, it is not here, it is anatma, and the enemy is anatma, friend is anatma. Then everything is anatma, then this statement, sarvam atmaiva bhut, doesn't apply. Sarvam atmaiva bhavati, when all the divisions, karta, karma, kriya, etc., phalam, etc., the entire vyavahara is negated and only atma is there. Therefore, for a jnani who realized the sarvatma bhava, there is not a single thing which is anatma. Not a single thing which is anatma. Tasmat avidyayaiva anatmatvam parikalpitam. Therefore, by ignorance alone, the status of being anatma is imagined. It is ignorance that makes us believe that it is anatma. You see, the known is nothing but a shape. Known is nothing but a shape. And knowledge, nothing but a mere name. What you call knowledge is nothing but a mere name. Now suppose you look at the stars and say, you look at that star, this star, this star, three of them you see? Yeah, I have seen. And that is called some name. That is, and you say it is knowledge. Is it knowledge or name? Suppose I say, these 10 stars, they are Leo. It is a lion. You see, lion means first you have to remember lion. How does it look? Shake your head, lion, 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 and then try to see lion there. Okay? And you are not able to see lion. But a lion should have 2 ears. I don't see 2 ears. No, no, you see that star? Ah, yeah, that is the ear. And this star? Ah, this is another ear. Okay, I got both. So what you call lion, is it knowledge or is it a name, you tell me? Name. What you call knowledge is name. What you call known is but a shape. Then who is the knower? Knower is a mere state of mind. And atma, it resolves all these things in itself and remains beyond all these divisions. And therefore, knower, known, knowledge, triputi, when it is resolved, as we have seen in the morning also, now what is anatma? There is no anatma left. For something to be anatma, I must be the knower atma and that must be the known anatma. There is no anatma left. And whenever you imagine anatma, it is due to ajnana only. Natu paramarthataha atma vyatirekena asti kinchit. I tell you, really speaking, other than Atma, Atma Vyatirekena, essentially there is nothing other than atma paramarthatah atma vyatirekena kinchidapi nasti. You see, what happens is there is the mind which is the knower, and there is the mind which is the means of knowing, pramana, and there is the mind which is the known. And so the mind itself creates the division. You know this? Mind knows an object by becoming that object. You know that? You know that? That much you can understand. That's why we call it manovritti. Now I will tell you one thing. Mind knows, now you understand this correctly. Mind knows an object by becoming the object. That much is clear? Now I am giving one more statement. Mind knows the other by becoming the other. Okay? So now what you call, it is the other. How do you know it is the other? Because I know it, therefore it is the other. Yeah. Whatever you know it, you become that. That's why when you say my sofa, you become the sofa. So anyway, you think about it. So this is how mind, it divides itself into knower, known, and the means of knowing. And it clogs up, clogs ourselves with the images and ideas. And these images and ideas, they leave scars in memory. Grooves are scars in memory. And then out of those scars left in the memory by mind, those images, etc., out of those grooves we recollect. Whatever is formed as a groove, that comes out as a recollection. And that recollected thing, we call it knowledge. And that knowledge is what is doing now. This knowledge is standing as a wall between atma and making something else as anatma. I know it, therefore it is the other. Therefore, what you call knowledge is nothing but a group of ideas and images that are scarred or that are imprinted in the mind. That's why I often say, unless there is the operation of the mind, you cannot have a world other than you. And you cannot have yourself different from the world. You see, there is the body. Inside the body, there appears to be an observer. And outside the body, there is a world under observation. Right? You see, you understand the observer and the observed world. Under the process of observation, all of these things appear and disappear together. And Atma is beyond all of them. And Atma, you arrive at the pure reality of Atma when the observer and the observed world and the process of observation, everything is resolved in Atma. And therefore, when you arrive at the world, arrive at the Atma as the only reality, there is nothing other than Atma. Only there is the other, as long as you stand inside the body as observer. Therefore, unless you are inside the body as an observer, there is no world, observed world other than you. Therefore, this otherness comes because of that observer fixed inside the body. Once you know that you are pure awareness, you are not the observer inside the body, you are the awareness pure, in which even the body comes to light, in which even the observer comes to light. In that situation, the observed world cannot be outside that Atma. It is also included in the Atma Chaitanyam alone. Therefore, Atma Vyatirekena Kinchidapi Nasti Tasmat Paramarthatmaikatva Pratyaye Kriyakaraka Phala Pratyaya Nupapattihi. You see, Pratyaya is a unit of knowledge. That is the Pratyaya. Okay? Now, if you say, I am the karta, this is the kriya, this is the karma, and these are the objects that I have to use in this karma, karakas, and this will give you this phala. How many units of knowledge? Half a dozen units of knowledge. As long as you retain that, Atma Jnana will be away from you. Okay? And then, kriya, karaka, phala, all of this is the mind itself splitting into so many parts. What you call karta is the mind, what you call karana is the mind, what you call karma is the mind, what you call heaven is the mind, everything is mind only. And mind alone is splitting itself in all these parts and it is appearing like that. And therefore mind is nothing but a movement or a ripple in the awareness absolute. The divisions that the mind creates are not real in that awareness absolute. And the awareness absolute alone is the reality. That is what is called paramartha atma ekatva pratyaya. The real Atma, which is one without the second, and that realization. So when that realization is there, these multiple ideas, I am karta, this is karma, that is phala, I will get this, I will get that, all these things will not be there. They just cease. They just resolve. For a jnani, I am karta, I am bhokta, this phalam is there, this karma has to be done, I have to enjoy this, I have to... All of this is just ceases. That kind of movement will not be there for a jnani. And that's why the jnani has only one movement. It is not even movement, one clear realization that all is Atma and all these divisions are nothing but unreal movements of the mind. अतः विरोधात् ब्रह्मविदः क्रियाणां तत्साधनानां च अत्यन्तमेव निवृत्तिः. सी ए ब्रह्मविद् वन्स वन हू नोस् दि ब्रह्मन् फॉर हिम ही इज नॉट ए कर्ता अंड there is no goal that needs to be accomplished for him. There is no phala. And when he is not a karta, and there is no goal to be accomplished, I told you, in a jnani's life, nothing ever goes wrong. And therefore, he need not correct anything. He need not embellish anything. Will the screen try to embellish and correct something that appears on the screen? It will never do that. The screen will never do that. A jnani is like that. Therefore, for him, the kriyas and the goals that have to be accomplished by the kriyas and the various implements that are needed to fulfill these kriyas, to make those kriyas to happen, all of that is gone back. Atyantameva nivurtihi. They are all totally resolved. That's why this notion that Shankara went round, he went round all right. He's a Parivrajaka, therefore he went round. And wherever he went, he defeated this person, he defeated that person. And then he constructed a building there, and in that building he started an organization. All these things are imaginations of the poets. If you study Bhashya, you will not get carried away by all this. So, suppose Shankara looks at the world. I am a Dvaiti, these are all Dvaitis, these are all my enemies, whereas these are my friends. Then you call him an Advaiti? Therefore, for a jnani, all these divisions and a life of activity based on the sense that I am a doer, a life of activity based on the sense that this and this goal has to be accomplished, such a thing is unheard of. You cannot imagine even in the wildest of dreams. For a jnani, a natural thing happens naturally. So, atyantameva nivurtihi kena kimiti kshepartham vachanam. ప్రకారాంతర అనుపపత్తి ప్రదర్శనార్థం. ఐ థింక్ వీ విల్ లీవ్ ఇట్ ఫర్ టుమారో మార్నింగ్. ఓం పూర్ణమద పూర్ణమిదం పూర్ణాత్ పూర్ణముదశ్యతే పూర్ణస్య పూర్ణమాదాయ పూర్ణమేవాశిష్యతే. ఓం శాంతి శాంతి శాంతి. హరి ఓం శ్రీ గురుభ్యో నమః. హరి ఓం తత్సత్. శ్రీకృష్ణార్పణమస్తు.